विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, आज आपण पॅरलल लाईन अँड देअर ट्रान्सव्हर्सल हे इयत्ता 8वी मधील दुसरं प्रकरण अभ्यासणार आहोत। या प्रकरणामध्ये दोन समांतर रेषा आणि त्यांची छेदिका या घटकाचा आपल्याला अभ्यास करावयाचा आहे। पॅरलल लाईन्स अँड ट्रान्सव्हर्सल इन दिस चॅप्टर यू विल सी First, definition of two parallel line when two lines do not intersect in each any point then these lines are called parallel line and when a line intersect these two line in two different point then this line is the transversal of that line when a transversal intersect two parallel line in two distinct point then eight angles are formed in these eight angles there are the some pair of angles in this chapter you will see about these pair of the angle these eight angles are formed by the transversal like this these are the eight angles formed by the transversal non intersecting coplanar lines are called the parallel lines if a line intersect given two lines in two distinct point then that line is called the transversal of those line and when two lines are parallel to each other and any other line intersect in two point then eight angles are formed in these eight angles there are the four pair of the corresponding angle pair there are four pair of the corresponding angle and their intersection is a ray and there have an distinct vertices in these four pair first pair is angle PQA and angle QRC this is the first pair of the corresponding angle pair and another pair is angle QPQB and angle QRD this is the second pair of the corresponding angle and third pair is angle QAQR and angle CRT this is the third pair of the corresponding pair of angle and this is the fourth pair of the corresponding angle angle BQR and angle DRT this is the fourth pair of the corresponding angle each pair of corresponding angle formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is congruent angles then when a transversal intersect two parallel line in two distinct point then two pair of the alternate angles are formed in this alternate pair of angle one angle is angle AQR this is the first pair of angle angle QRD this angle AQR and angle QRD these two angles are the alternate pair of angle and another alternate pair of angle is BQR and QRD this is the second pair of the alternate angle angle BQR and angle CRQ these two angles are the congruent angle also each pair of alternate angle formed by two parallel line and their transversal is congruent lines and third pair of angle is interior angle pair there are two pairs of interior angle but these two angles do not congruent to each other but there is the one property interior angle are supplementary this is the first pair angle AQR and angle QRC this is the first pair of interior angle and the sum of these two angle is 180 degree that means this pair of two angle is supplementary angle because the sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Then this is the second pair, angle BQR and angle QRD. This is the second pair of interior angle, and sum of these two angles also 180 degree. That means each pair of interior angle formed by two parallel lines and their transversal is of supplementary angles. Then in the figure, line AB and line PQ and line LM is a transversal if angle MNQ is equal to 70 degree. Then you have to find out angle AON. Angle MNQ is equal to 70 degree. Then you have to find out the measurement of angle AON. So you will see the measurement of this angle is 70 degree, and opposite angle of angle QNM is also 70 degree. When this angle is measurement of angle is 70 degree, then this angle and this angle are the supplementary angle by interior angle pair. So sum of these two angle is 180 degree. So angle AON is equal to 110 degree. Measurement of angle AON is 110 degree. So angle LOB is also 180 degree. This angle and this angle is the pair of linear pair of angle. So sum of these two angle is also 180 degree, and angle LOA is equal to 70 degree, and angle NOB is also 70 degree. You have to write this example. First you will solve like this, then you will solve the example. Measurement of angle MNQ is equal to angle ONP. These two angles are the opposite angle, so measure of these two angles is equal to 70 degree. Then measurement of angle AON plus measurement of angle ONP is equal to 180 degree. This is the interior pair of angle, so measurement of angle AON is equal to 180 degree minus measurement of angle ONP, but ONP is equal to 70 degree. So measurement of angle AON is equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree. So measurement of angle AON is equal to 110 degree. In figure, line M parallel to line N and line L is the transversal. If measurement of angle B is equal to X plus 50 degree and measurement of angle E is equal to 2X plus 15 degree, you have to find out the value of X here. In this figure, measurement of angle B congruent to measurement of angle F, B and F, these two angles are the corresponding pair of angles. Measurement of angle F plus is equal to measurement of angle B is equal to X plus 15. F is equal to B is equal to X plus 15 degree. Then measurement of angle F plus measurement of angle E is equal to 180 degree. F plus E is equal to 180 degree. This is the linear pair of angle. So measurement of F is X plus 15 plus measurement of angle E is equal to given 2X plus 15 is equal to 180 degree. X plus 2X is equal to 3X. 15 plus 15 is equal to 30 degree. So 3x plus 30 degree is equal to 180 degree. So 3x is equal to 180 degree minus 30 degree, and 3x is equal to 150 degree. So the value of x is equal to 150 upon 3. So x is equal to 15 degree, you have to find out in this example value of x, and value of x is 50 degree. In figure, line M parallel to line N and line L is the transversal. If angle B is equal to x plus 15 degree and angle E is equal to 2x plus 15 degree, angle B is equal to x plus 15 and angle E is equal to 2x plus 15 degree, you have to find out the value of x here. Angle B is equal to x plus 15, x is equal to 15 plus 15 degree is equal to 65 degree, and measurement of angle B is equal to measurement of angle M plus measurement of angle D is equal to measurement of angle F is equal to measurement of angle H is equal to 65 degree, and M is equal to E is equal to 2x plus 15, 2 into 50 plus 50, so is equal to 100 plus 50 is equal to 150 degree. Measurement of angle E is equal to measurement of angle G is equal to measurement of angle A is equal to measurement of angle C is equal to 150 degree.